Welcome to the Royce episode of this week. We believe that God has something for us, and we want to listen to what God wants to speak to that young person out there. And I know that the Lord is going to bless us. We would want to thank all our subscribers. We are now over 500 people that have subscribed to this channel. And we thank you so much. May God bless you. And if you have not yet subscribed to The Royce, I tell you, you are missing. Just subscribe and you'll always be getting encouraging and motivating messages from this channel as a young person. And even as a parent there, it will help you to encourage your child. God bless you, even as we continue. The topic of my message today is, it is finished. We all of us, we know that when our Lord Jesus Christ died on the cross for your sin and for my sin, just before he gave up his spirit, he said these wonderful words that are powerful, that it is finished. That is in the book of John chapter 19 and verse 30. So when Jesus had received the sour wine, he said, it is finished. And bowing his head, he gave up his spirit. What did Jesus mean when he talked about it is finished? This one encourages us in one or two things, if we can think about what Christ talked about. When Jesus said it is finished on the cross, what did he mean? Christ knew that once he is gone, we'll be undergoing a lot of challenges and we'll be in this life, and he wanted to encourage us. So one thing that he meant when he said that it is finished, he meant that the debt of our sins is fully paid. Remember when Adam and Eve sinned in the Garden of Eden, all of us became sinners. And therefore Christ came and died to pay the debt of sin. And therefore he said it is finished. And therefore to those that believe in the death and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, and you have confessed him as your Lord and Savior, the debt of your sin is fully paid. Number two, he meant the judgment and punishment for us, for what we deserve, the time of being in bondage is over. So when you are a sinner and you are living in sin, actually you live in bondage. You are not free. You sin, you feel you are guilty. When you enter into sin, you come out of it, you feel like you are not happy. Uko na huzuni, haufurahi. Why? You are in bondage of the devil. So when you believe in Jesus Christ and his death and the completed work of the cross, it means that the judgment, it is already, and the punishment we deserve because of what we have done, because of our sins, it is fully served. And therefore, you find that you live a free life, you feel, you'll walk in this life feeling not condemned at all, because you know the debt and the judgment is already fully served. And number three, he meant the battle against the devil is already won. That as we live in this life, we walk and contend with the work of the evil one. And you find that you are always being pulled to do what is not right. At times you feel like you want to give up. At times you feel like you are even going to commit suicide. Actually, we have many young people who are committing suicide these days. Why? Because of condemnation in themselves. The devil is against our young people and contending with them, until they feel like they're not worth living. I was listening to one mother. She was giving the experience of how what she went through with one of her son who had committed suicide at home. And as she was talking about how they took, as she was cutting the rope where he had hung himself, because he had hung himself at the corridor of the home. And when the mother came out and found the son is already hanging there, dangling, the body dangling there, she had to cut the rope. And as they took the body to the mortuary, she was saying that they met with almost six more parents who were suffering the same. They were taking their young ones and they had already committed suicide. And I was asking myself, what is it that is so difficult, young people out there, that you cannot share with your parents? You cannot have a role model whom you can share with to be able to model you and to tell you that you can go through this life and don't kill yourself. In fact, I was listening again to one of the comedians. And he was telling young people, when you feel like ukisikia kama unataka kujiua kwa sababu mambo ni mengi, ukichukua hiyo kamba, anasema, alikuwa nawaambia kwa Kikuyu, alafu anawaambia, shulia madhina, where the rugedo, what you do, what he meant is, you feel this is heavy, I'm going to kill myself, what you do. Weka hizo hiyo, yani forget about those problems. Hang them somewhere and forget and walk the journey. What does it mean to walk the journey? Get a friend you can talk to. Maybe your parents. Maybe you're not free with your parents. Get somebody who can mentor you. Somebody whom you can share your heart with. And what you realize is that what you're experiencing and what you're going through, it is not new. Kuna wengi wamepitia hiyo njia na wame manage to come out. But the most important thing to put in mind is all these things that we are going through, any condemnation that the devil is putting in your heart and in your life, the battles you are going through for in life, know that Christ died on the cross. Na akasema, it is finished. The battle is won. Na uki target that I'm going to follow Christ, I will focus my eyes on Christ. You are going to win those battles, those wars, against maybe sickness, against any manner of diseases, maybe viruses like what we are going through. And you find that you come out the other side victorious and go to the next level. Rest in the finished work of the cross. And then you'll know that Jesus fights the battle for you. And you and I, we enjoy the victory, but we have to accept Christ and allow him to be our Lord and Savior and guide us. And number two, how do we make sure that Christ is involved in our lives so that we have this confidence? We are able to say what I'm telling you today, that you are able to know that Christ paid this for you. One, you must have a relationship with him through reading the Word of God and through prayer. If you find that you get bored where the Word of God is being read, when you go to church, you are bored, where you can't pray, you stay for 3 weeks, you have never prayed by yourself, that is a danger zone. Make a relationship with Christ. Pray every day. Read the Word of God. In fact, I was looking at one of the nations of the world. In one of the developed nations, what did they do? They kicked God out of their schools. They kicked God out of their public places, that you cannot be free to have a crusade and all that. In 1962, the Supreme Court of that nation removed Bible reading from public schools. That is not something, that's weird. That is, when I came to know that, you find that it is not something that is acceptable. Then in 1963, they removed prayers from their public schools, that you cannot pray. Now you wonder, where will our young people put their faith? Then the Christ, after they did that, the crisis among young people of that nation is unimaginable. Why? You find that suicide cases rose to about 300%. Unwed pregnancies of young people rose 600%. The rate of juvenile violent crimes rose exponentially. You find that there are so many crimes of young people, juvenile. The ones that are supposed to be in juvenile, there are many. And then you find that the scores in the exams, the students started dropping by nearly 10%, even though they have spent so much of their revenue in education. Why? One thing they didn't know, the government of that nation didn't know, the national leaders had kicked out, or they had taken away something very, very important, very, very precious in the lives of these young people. Therefore, when you remove Christ from your life, you leave a vacuum. And in that vacuum, if it is left like that, there are demons of confusion, and destruction that come to fill the life. And that is what happened in this nation. And even when we come home here, Kenya, it is, we are finding the same thing, where God, our young people are not able to relate well with God. They are not able they don't want to be in their camps, to be taught the word of God, to be in church, to pray. They just want to be left free. You find there is a lot of danger in the lives of those young people. So what is the remedy of this? It is welcoming Christ back in our lives, back in our schools, back in our lives, that all these challenges are going to be finished, and we'll always be able to tell the devil, I will not walk a defeated life because I know it is finished. And therefore, may God bless you, even as you continue to chew the card over the word of this week. God bless you.